The Mamata Banerjee-led TMC government in Bengal recently passed a resolution to create a legislative council. But it's now expected to become the latest flashpoint between Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee and Prime Minister Modi. So why does Bengal suddenly want to get its upper house back after it abolished it 52 years ago? Let's decode this for you. What's a legislative council? The Vidhan Parishad is called the state's legislative council. The system of the legislative councils began during the British rule. In fact, the Government of India Act of 1935 had set up bicameral legislatures in Indian provinces, and it was under this law that Bengal got a legislative council as far back as 1937. Why was the Bengal Legislative Council dissolved? In 1969, the United Front stormed back to power with more than a two-thirds majority, and soon after, it passed a resolution for the abolition of the Legislative Council altogether. Months later, Parliament agreed and West Bengal Legislative Council was abolished. Why does Mamata Banerjee want Bengal's upper house back now? One of the top reasons behind the Legislative Council revival is whether Mamata Banerjee can continue to be in the Chief Minister's chair. While TMC swept the Bengal Assembly election, she lost her own seat, and that is still unclear as to how soon a bipoll will be conducted by the Election Commission, especially now given the COVID crisis. In Uttarakhand, for example, BJP's Teerath Singh Rawat faced a similar situation as Mamata Banerjee and eventually resigned as the Chief Minister just days ago. How much time does Mamata Banerjee have now? According to the rule book, Mamata Banerjee has at least 6 months till the first week of November in which she can get elected to the Assembly in order to continue as the Chief Minister of West Bengal. Having an upper house will of course help Bengal avoid such a crisis, because members indirectly elected to the Legislative Council can serve in the cabinet of a state. Why is BJP really against this? The BJP has now called this backdoor politics to help party leaders get elected as lawmakers, despite having lost the assembly polls. BJP legislators have said that it would be unnecessary financial drain on the state's resources. The TMC now has hit back by pointing out at Uttar Pradesh, Karnataka and Bihar as classic examples of three states which have an upper house, despite the BJP currently being in power within those states. And while the war of words between the TMC and the BJP might continue over the issue in Bengal, this impasse is unlikely to be resolved anytime soon.